الحمد لله، الحمد لله والثناء لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحابته ومن والاه، ما بعد. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. قال الله تبارك تعالى واصدق القائلين: وذكر فإن الذكرى تنفع المؤمنين وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون. الحمد لله. Dear brothers, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And amongst the condition for Allah to continue to bless you is to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, لَإِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. How many of our brothers are their brothers around who are Muslim? How many of our own family members who we sometimes know and we sleep together, we eat together, and we know that they do not even pray? You know that is the path to Jahannam. You know if they die that way, you will be asked in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know that when you pray alone, it is not enough. قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا قُوْ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَهْلِيكُمْ نَارًا. Have you ever imagined if that room was to be an oven, you are to be allowed to walk in for only 2 minutes inside the oven? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the fire of dunya has been put off 70 times. The fire of akhirah is 70 times of equivalent. 1 minute in the oven, imagine 1 minute, or even one night if you have to be forced to be locked inside the oven. How are you going to be? At the end of it, after being locked in there with all these difficulties, if you are told to pray Salatul Fajr, Wallahi, you'll be the first one. Because you will not want to go back again in there. You know the punishment. But Sayyidina Ali, Rahmatullahi alayhi wa karramallahu wajha, he said, Al-yawma amalun wala hisab. Wa ghadan hisabun wala amal. Today in this dunya, dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us commandments. He has sent Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to guide us. اليوم عمل ولا حساب. Do it. وقل اعملوا فسيرى الله عملكم ورسوله والمؤمنون. You do it, and I'm telling you, do this and that, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the witness. If you don't do it, dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be questioned for each and every thing. Therefore, dear brothers, it is a responsibility. The responsibility. And also, dear brothers, when we want to convey the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our language, they say two dead people cannot bury one another. If you are dead and the second person is dead, they cannot bury one another. A person who is alive will have to come and bury them. Therefore, if we have problems, our hearts have problems, our salat have problems, our tongues have problems, our ears, our time, we are wasting. Therefore, how are we going to treat others? If a doctor is sick, he's very ill, he's got temperature problems, how is he going to go to the surgery to write prescription for others? It is not possible. Therefore, we start ourselves. They say, Ya Amir al-Nasi qad asbahta muttahama idh ibta umuran anta ta'tiha. They say, Ibda bin, you someone who is going to want to guide people. He said, إِذْ عِبْتَ أُمُورًا أَنْتَ تَأْتِيهَا. You are saying this is bad, don't do this, don't do that. And then do this and that. أَنْتَ تَأْتِيهَا. You are doing the opposite. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are in the month of Rajab. The month where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was taken to the seven heavens, that we have to believe that this has taken place. Otherwise, your Islam will be questionable. Because the salat that you are praying is the fact that you believe that journey has taken place. One of the things that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the purpose of that journey, لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the things that he has witnessed, some people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent, they are getting punished with scissors being taken and their tongues being cut regularly. And then as soon as it finishes, it comes back again and it is done again. The Prophet has asked Sayyidina Jibreel, "Man ha'ula ya Jibreel?" He said, "Khutaba'ul fitna." He said, "These are the people who will convey the message, they will do the opposite." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even in the Quran, few places, He challenges us. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu lima taquluna ma la taf'alun. In another place in Surah Al-Baqarah, He said, "Ata'muruna an-nasa bil birri wa tansawna anfusakum wa antum tatluna al-kitaba afala ta'qilun?" How are you telling me this and that and the other while you do the opposite completely? Therefore, dear brothers, wallahi, one of the sheikh, he said, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, immediately as soon as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gifted him the iman, the kalima la ilaha illallah, was immediately working on it in bringing others towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those who are nominated to go to Jannah, five of them, if not more, are on his record. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, look at the beauty of conveying the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, addalu ala al-khayri kafa'ilihi. If you show someone the way to do something, you will be rewarded until that person passes away and their children, because they will go and convey the message to one another. Because if one person, if the husband is guided, the likelihood he will take that message at home. The mother will be guided. The children will be guided. The children, and also they will take it to the children and pass it on. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Look, the condition is this: مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ. You are calling people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. You start doing the good first. Because sometimes da'wah of quietness is better than da'wah of speaking. Sometimes somebody just looking at your akhlaq, the way you speak to people, the way you smile to them, the way you help them, looking at you, subhanallah, people, sometimes it is said, the ulama, the people who are conscious of Allah, who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even without speaking, sometimes if people see them, they're just walking. If they're smoking, they will throw it away. If they're doing anything bad, they will cover themselves. Why the alim or the sheikh is just passing away, passing by? He has not even spoken. Therefore, my dear brothers, our actions is much more important than speaking. Because today, you will see, at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, fiqh was not there. The books of fiqh was not there. Riyadu Salihina that we have today, it was not there. The books of the hadith, Bukhari, Muslim, and all, they were not there. The Quran itself, the way it is, at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, it was not even there. Look at the Sahabas, the difference and everything. But the Prophet ﷺ was there, the knowledge and everything. But today, alhamdulillah, there's so many books. There's so many people who are speaking to others and everything, but it is not taking effect. One of the things, one of the ulama, they was explaining, he said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in saying this beautiful hadith, بَلِّغُوا عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً, he said, it is divided into three parts. بَلِّغُوا تَكْلِيف, it is a responsibility. فِعْلُ أَمْر, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us, بَلِّغُوا, secondly, عَنِّي تَشْرِيف, when you are saying the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it has more value than when I just say it. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this. Sayyidina Muhammad used to do this. It has more effect than when I tell you somebody outside has said this or that. بَلِّغُوا عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً. He said, وَلَوْ آيَةً تَخْفِيف. It was made simple, even one single verse. He said, but what makes this difficult out of all the three, it is the middle one. عَنِّي, he said, in following me, following my akhlaq, following the way I used to sleep, following the way I used to do, when someone sees you, immediately they can see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They will see the actions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. بَلِّغُ عَنِّي, from me. Otherwise he would have taken عَنِّي بَلِّغُ وَلُوْ آيَةً. He would have said, he would have made the same
The same meaning, the same meaning, but he's connected it to himself and his actions. The akhlaq of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Therefore, dear brothers, it is a responsibility. One of the ulama, when he came to visit us, he said, if Allah asks you, you have been to a country like this for probably 10 years, 20 years and more, how many did you bring to Islam? What will be your answer in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How many did you push away from Islam? Wallahi, dear brothers, I go to work in a pharmacy, and I went to work for 3 days in one particular pharmacy. And the lady who I was working with, it was Salatul Dhuhr, I went and I said, 5 minutes inshallah, I am praying, coming back. I will spread my break. 5 minutes Asr, I'll come back. Not going out, just quickly in the room, I'll pray and come back. Salatul Maghrib, similarly. She was very impressed. Second day, same. Third day, I said, I am very impressed and know that you are Muslim. Because before you, there was another man who was a Muslim. He said, first day he was worried, where can I buy halal food? Second day, where can I buy halal food? Lunch, I'm hungry. Around here, there's no halal food. Third day, she said, I told him, why are you bothered about halal food? You don't pray even once. You can even eat pigs. It doesn't matter because a Muslim prays. Subhanallah, he was shocked, that man. A non-Muslim giving a da'wah to a Muslim. He said, he was very shocked. Shocked. He said, why are you worried? Huh? Al-farqu baynana wa bayna ghayru al-muslimin as-salat. He said, the difference, it is salat. Therefore, if you do not even bother about salat, why are you bothered what you eat? Because there is no communication between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why are you worried what you eat? So therefore, dear brothers, it is a responsibility when someone looks at you, they know that you are Muslim. Wallahi, sometimes you will wear well and everything. Someone will ask you, even a hijab. A lady just going with a hijab is da'wah immediately. Therefore, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, dear brothers, where we are getting our priorities wrong, is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said 4 things. Inna Allaha la yanzuru ila suwarikum wala amwalikum, walakin yanzuru ila qulubikum wa a'malikum. These 4 things. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is not interested in your appearance. This is a big thing. This differentiates. Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. The best amongst you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not interested whether you're black, whether you're white, whether you're from that country, this country. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is not interested whether you're Arab, non-Arab and everything. Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. The best thing the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has learned. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Najm, he said, laqad ra'a min ayati rabbihi al-kubra. The Prophet ﷺ has witnessed some of the amazing ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the things that he has witnessed inside the Jannah, when the Prophet ﷺ was taken to Jannah, the Prophet ﷺ could hear someone walking. When he asked Sayyidina Jibreel, who is this already here? He said, this is Sayyidina Bilal. Sayyidina Bilal. Why has he got to that level, dear brothers? The Prophet ﷺ, immediately he came to Sayyidina Bilal. He said, oh Bilal, you've gone to Jannah before us. What is it that you do that we can learn from you? He said, ya Rasulullah, this is a very simple thing that we can bring to our life. He said, every time my wudu breaks, therefore I go and continue to be in the state of wudu. And every time I take wudu, I pray 2 rak'ah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very simple. How long does it take? Not a lot. But it is a sunnah that we don't even bother. I was reading in one of the books, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Sayyidina Musa, if you are not in the state of wudu, therefore whatever happens, do not blame me. said, remain in the state of wudu regularly at all times. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, one of the signs that I will recognize you in the day of judgment is the signs of your wudu. He said, the places of wudu, they will come with noor. He said, therefore, if you can put it up, do it more. If on your legs and the noor, because non-Muslims, they don't perform wudu. The Jews, they don't perform wudu. Therefore, immediately, as soon as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sees you, you will see the noor of wudu. Therefore, dear brothers, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna Allah la yanzuru ila suwarikum." Allah subhanahu wa taala, He is not interested in your looks, whether you are short, whether you are tall. Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he is this tall, but he made a history. Once he went on top of a tree, and the Sahabas, they will see how long his legs are. They are tiny legs, and some of them started laughing. He said, the Prophet ﷺ told them, "Wallahi, those legs in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are heavier than the mountain of Uhud." When the verses of Surah Ar-Rahman, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed, the Prophet ﷺ said, who can go to the parliament of the non-believers, which is Al-Kaaba at that time, and recite Surah Ar-Rahman? Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, I will do that. Imagine telling you now, go to the parliament, houses of parliament, go in there and read Surah Ar-Rahman. How difficult. The police is and problems, and maybe you'll be beaten, maybe you are a terrorist, maybe you might be killed and everything else. But he said, I will do it. The Prophet ﷺ said, don't do that. You're little and you're weak. These people, Jababira, Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, and others, they will beat you. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I will go. And he went on there and he started reading Ar-Rahman, Allam al-Quran, Khalaq al-Insan, Allamahu al-Bayan. They started beating him so much that he was bleeding. Even his ears were bleeding. He came in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started laughing. Not jokingly or something. He said, Ya Rasulullah, after I've been beaten and all these, and you're laughing at me. He said, no, I am not laughing at you. He said, I was shown that Abu Jahl, he will die in your hands. Abu Jahl, the leader of the kuffar, he will die in your hands. That is why I am laughing. He said, but I told you you are weak and all this. He said, Ya Rasulullah, my iman is so strong as the Jabal of Uhud. If you tell me to go again, I will go again. That is yaqeen and iman they had for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are getting beaten at their brothers. Sayyidina Bilal getting beaten. He would continue saying, Ahadun, Ahad. Why? Because they've tested the iman and yaqeen at their brothers. Why were they ready in the seventh year of Nubuwa until 10th in difficulty? The Sahabas, they were ready to eat grass for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They were eating grass. Why? Because they understood. They had the yaqeen. Wallahi, we do not have the yaqeen in our heart, my dear brothers. Wallahi, if I was to stand outside and I tell everyone in Salatul Jum'ah after I finish the khutbah, whoever prays Salatul Fajr, I will stand outside and give them £100. Do you think the mosque will be empty? The masjid will be full. I will go bankrupt. Why? They have the yaqeen of cash in hand. Sayyidina Ali, he said, Al-yawma amalun wala hisab. No one will count you today. Why did you not come? Why did you come? We will come and remind you. The rest we leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua for you. If you come, alhamdulillah. If you do not come, but he said, wa ghadan hisabun wala amal. Tomorrow night, if you enter your grave, even if you wish to perform two raka'ah, it will not be possible. رَبِّ ارْجِعُونِ أَعْمَلُ صَالِحًا فِي مَا تَرَكْتُ كَلَّا. Oh Allah, give me one more extra minute. وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ فَيَقُولَ رَبِّ لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَى أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ. Why? فَأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Ya Allah, give me one extra minute, please, so that I can pay the charity, So that when they were raising the fund for the masjid, for the orphans, Ya Allah, I want to give it. I have seen the angel. Wa akun min as-salihin, Ya Allah, I want to be in good people. Because the Prophet ﷺ said, you will not depart this dunya until you see where you're going. When you are going, where you're going in Jannah or the hellfire, you will be shown. Therefore, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, Man ahabba liqa' Allahi ahabba Allahu liqa'ah. If you love to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love to meet you. وَمَنْ كَرِهَ لِقَاءَ اللَّهِ كَرِهَ اللَّهُ لِقَاءَهُ. If you hate to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hate meeting you. Sayyidina Aisha said, Ya Rasulullah, we all love to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but we don't like death. He said, it is not that, Ya Aisha. He said, when Allah shows you where you are going, and the beauty that you have prepared for you, you will love to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is, it is said, the janazah of a good person, it cries, Qaddimuni, Qaddimuni. Please take me quickly. That is the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. A Muslim dies as quickly as possible, he should be buried. For two reasons. One, if he is a good person, immediately to start getting the thawab. If he is a bad person, to get rid of that things that are coming inside the house. If it is a bad person, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, Ya laytaha, ayna tadhabuna biha. I was shown that I'm going to Jahannam. A good person, the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in that particular time, an invitation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come. Ya ayyatuha nafsul mutma'inna, irji'i ila rabbiki radiyatan mardiyya. Come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A little test that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, you have passed. Come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, radiyatan mardiyya. Allah is pleased with you. Allahu Akbar, my dear brother. When you are departing this dunya, to get a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that is pleased with you. And He will make you pleased. You will be pleased for what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for you. Not only that. Radiyatan mardiyya. Fadkhuli fi ibadi. Allahu Akbar. Come and join the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Come and join the Sahabas. Come and join the good people. Wadkhuli jannati. Come and enter my Jannah. This is the Jannah that we used to promise you all these times. Come and enter my Jannah. As soon as you land your grave, my dear brothers, the Jannah. Tomorrow night, if you end up in your grave, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the windows of Jannah. It is not long. And the hellfire that we hear, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, the grave, imma rawdatun min riyadil Jannah, aw hufratun min hufarin niran. Either is beautiful gardens of the gardens of Jannah, this grave, or it is part of the hellfire burning immediately. And that could be tomorrow night, I tell you. Wallahi, in here, if I tell you to raise your hand that you can guarantee to come and pray Salatul Isha, you will be alive. You will not. No one can raise their hand. If I tell you, please raise your hand if you 100% you will be alive to come and pray Salatul Isha. That is how short your life is. Therefore, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inshallah, to go back to the hadith, said, "Inna Allah la yanzuru ila suwarikum, wala ila amwalikum." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is not interested in your finances, in your money, how much you have in your bank. Wallahi, you will have so much amount of money, and there will be an appeal, people dying and everything. You will not even have rahmah in your heart to give them, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Wama tuqaddimu li anfusikum." مِنْ خَيْرٍ تَجِدُوهُ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. If you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for yourself. One of the ulama, he said, as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, اشْتَرُوا جَنَّتِي بِمَالِي. Buy my Jannah using my own money. Because the money, you will leave it here. Therefore, dear brothers, the Prophet ﷺ said, لَنْ يَزُولَ قَدَمَ عَبْدٍ حَتَّى يُسْأَلْ عَنْ أَرْبَعَ. He said, one of the things that you will be asked 100% before you take any part, whether to go to Jannah or the hellfire. وَعَنْ مَالِهِ مِنْ أَيْنَ اكْتَسَبَهُ وَفِيمَ أَنْفَقَ. How did you get this money? حَلَالُهَا حِسَابٌ وَحَرَامُهَا عِقَابٌ. Sayyidina Ali said, rahmatullahi alayh, he said, if you got in halal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want to know each and everything. When that appeal was there, why did you not pay? when that a Muslim was sleeping hungry? Why did you have that big balance? When this, when that, and the other. وَحَرَامُهَا عِقَابٌ. If you earn that money in the haram way, there is a punishment. Therefore, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ صُوَرِكُمْ وَلَا إِلَىٰ أَمْوَالِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has even warned us. He said, إِنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَةً. It is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَكِنْ يَنْظُرُ إِلَىٰ قُلُوبِكُمْ وَإِلَىٰ أَعْمَالِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is here that He will look at. Your intentions. Look at the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the love He has for us. As soon as you put an intention to do a good deed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders the angel to write the rewards immediately. I put an intention to build the mosque. Give them the rewards of building the mosque if the intention is true. But dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at the heart and how dirty is our heart. We don't like this one. We don't talk to this one. We hate this one. The heart is dirty. Therefore, dear brothers, the ulama tell us that when the doctor tells you that if you eat certain medication, it will give you gastric problems. If you eat chili, it will give you gastric problems. Therefore, similarly, the ruh itself, there are certain things that it is allergic to. Sins. If you are sending sins to your own ruh, to the heart, it weakens the heart. It weakens your iman. The iman becomes weak. Regularly, you know that if I eat chili, if you go to the gastric problems, indigestion, if you eat chili, you cannot even sleep. Difficult. If you have cholesterol, if you eat a lot of oily food, you cannot even, it is dangerous. You can give you a heart attack. If you have blood pressure, if you eat salty food, the heart can even collapse. But when we know that the sins are dangerous for our heart, for our ruh, we continuously, it doesn't matter. The eyes are earning, the ears are earning, the tongues are earning, the legs are earning. It doesn't matter. You will not even care. You don't even think that I could depart this dunya after 1 hour. That there's a brother that you don't speak to for certain times. You do not even bother thinking, what will happen tomorrow when I'm in front of people, that they've brought me in front of people to be prayed upon. They said, when you are the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, when you are born, to perform the adhan on the right ear and the iqamah on the left ear. Therefore, and every sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, whenever the adhan is performed and the iqamah is performed, what follows is the salat. But where is the salat? If you are born in hospital, where is the salat? He says, the salat is the salatul janaza. صلوا علي صلاة لا ركوع لها ولا سجود لعل الله يرحمني. They prayed salat that doesn't have ركوع, doesn't have sujood. لعل الله يرحمني. One of the great grandchildren of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, زين العابدين ابن علي, he said, سفري بعيد وزادي لم يبلغني. He said, my journey is very long, and the little that I have done is not enough to last me my journey. It is said that he used to pray every night 1,000 rak'ah. And he's scared to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying the journey is very long. And وَزَادِي لَمْ يُبَلِّغُنِي وَقُوَّتِي ضَعُفَتْ وَالْمَوْتُ يَطْلُبُنِي. He said, I'm weakening every single day and the death is following me every single day. And their brother Sayyidina Abi Huraira, we do not open the hadith until you say, عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه وأرضاه. He was seen at the time of death. He was crying. And he was asked, يا أبا هريرة, what is wrong with you? He said, على طول السفر وقلة الزاد. He narrated 5,000 hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. 5,000. He was crying at the time of death, my dear brother. He said, ala tuli safar, the journey that I am going, it is long, it is lonely, in the grave, it is dark. Wa qillati zad, I have not done much to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he has given all his life for da'wah, all his life for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the life to narrate the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, to learn them so that he can report to us. So every one of us, whoever reads that is getting the rewards, he knows this. But he's still scared of it. But we think that we have guarantees. Tomorrow if I die, I'm walking to Jannah. We should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dear brothers. We have responsibilities. كُلُّكُمْ رَاعٍ وَكُلُّ رَاعٍ مَسْئُولٌ عَنْ رَعِيَّتِهِ. You have a responsibility to represent this deen in the correct way. You have the responsibility to convey the message of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Be grateful somebody has conveyed the message to you. There's someone who's left his family. There's someone who spent his money to make sure the deen has reached you. You have a responsibility to start with yourself, to start with your family, to start with those close members, and to start with your community, and then slowly, slowly. Otherwise, my dear brothers, if we are sick ourselves, as Muslims, we are sick ourselves. The example that I've given in the beginning, we said if a dead person and another dead person, they cannot bury one another. If we are dead, our heart is dead, how are we going to guide others? So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah, to bless our gatherings, inshallah. For those brothers who came all the way, inshallah, from Sweden, for every khatwa, inshallah, may Allah put in the mizan of hasanat. For those brothers who came around, inshallah, in this masjid, inshallah, we're welcoming you. A brother has asked me to come here. It would have been beautiful for me to sit and listen. He's asked me, inshallah, I wasn't prepared. If I've made any mistakes, inshallah, it's from me and shaitan. If it went well, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our iman. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us yaqeen. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way we met here with beautiful faces after praying salatul jama'ah, inshallah, to meet in Jannah with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers, we have our brother, Sheikh Hamza. Allah is working tirelessly with welcoming the brothers, taking them around, and doing the da'wah and taking the jama'ah to different locations. Inshallah ta'ala, we should make an effort, feel a responsibility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you. Because the first thing, wallahi, people who are sitting together, the soldiers of Allah are coming. The soldiers of Allah are coming. They were running people. People are seeing Jama'atul Tabligh coming to them while they're sitting. Ah, subhanAllah, the soldiers are coming, the soldiers of Allah. They were running to them. So you should fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us. Allahumma ja'al jam'ana hadha jam'an marhuma wa tafarruqana ba'dihi tafarruqan ma'suma wa la taj'al fina wa la ma'ana shaqiyan wa la mahruma. Allahumma ahdina bihudak wa la tuwallina waliyan siwak wa ja'alna mimman yusari'u fi ridak wa la taj'alna mimman khalafa amraka wa asak. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadait. Allahumma ahdina wa ahdi bina wa ja'alna sababan liman ihtada. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina 'adhaban nar wa adkhilna al-jannata ma'al abrari ya 'aziz ya غفار رحم الراحمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله.
الحمد لله. People have such a very quiet.